Hi everyone, Nathan Hall here, part two of our series on cars. This time we're going to look at directions, both in how to do things and how to tell people where to go. So, just curious who here is good at giving directions. I don't mean telling people what to do. The big activity here, we're going to look at verbs, verbos, actions, and prepositions of place, next to, near, and opposite, behind, forward, past. So if you know your way around your town, this will really help you. If not, you might learn something. And one thing that will come up, landmarks, famous things, things you can see easily, things that everyone knows about. Do you like giving street names or landmarks? We'll find out. So our standards objectives are here. So first we're going to look at how to get a car. This will be our directions on how to do something. This will be part of your assessments. Not sure if it'll be homework or quiz at this point. Maybe both. So we'll talk about this, how to get a car, the steps involved, and then how to take care of the car once you get it, some things to do. And then here's some vocabulary. This will be down below. We have the definitions. Negotiate, get a better price, register, sign the papers to make it official, title, this blue piece of paper for a car, also what a movie is called, check, I hope you check your grades a lot, and then a bit of slang because it's kind of fun, what it means if a car is a lemon. That won't be one of your questions, but I'm just curious what you guys think about that. So come to the live class, we'll discuss it. So then, rules of the road, since we'll do directions. These are directions in themselves. What happens if we go one way? What happens if we go the other way? What the rules are? And these signs, what do the signs mean? Okay, so in effect, these are giving you directions all the time. Ooh, one question I'd like to add. What if there were no laws? What if there was nothing there? Just go crazy if you can get behind the wheel. So we'll go over what the signs mean, some vocabulary there. Oh, there's the yield sign, okay. And then we'll look at our most important part, giving directions. This will be how you tell someone how to do something. Since you've been told what to do so much, your turn to tell someone what to do. It's all on you now. So here are the prepositions of place, here's some ways of doing it, here's some ways to read a map, which you will have to do for one of the upcoming activities. Read a map, see where things are. Good thing to know is to find the key in Espanol, la clave in the key in English, a clave en Espanol. So that shows where things are, the scale, la escala. This will come up in your math classes a lot, especially when they talk about proportion, how far something is in relation to something else. Remember, proportion, ratio is the same, even the numbers are different. Math teachers like to play tricks like that. That's what they do. So we have some terms here. It will come up for landmarks, and then for directions we'll talk about, and the live class will discuss some points of interest in your city. I know there are some. I've been to York, Allentown, and Reading. All have some interesting places. How well you can read maps. And when it comes to directions, do you like someone saying derecho o leste, izquierda o oeste, derecho o norte? So we'll talk about that in class. Norte, sorry. So be sure to go over the vocabulary. We'll talk about how to do maps in the live class, walk through the activities. Again, same rule applies as I always does for vocabulary. If it's not down below, it still might show up on your vocabulary quizzes or the big pod test. We'll go over all the words in the live classes. All the words are in the PowerPoints. Do your best. Any questions, let me know. Come to the live class. We'll be ready to go. Hasta la vista.